In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet using statistical models. So what we're going to be doing in this worksheet is looking at different types of data and then answering questions based on what we're given. So number one, it says the oyster population of the Chesapeake Bay has been in decline for over 100 years. This can be expressed by the equation y equals 41.6 times 0.969 to the x, where x is the number of years since 1900 and y is the amount of oysters harvested in metric tons. So our question associated with this information is, what does the y-intercept of this function represent? So the y-intercept is where our graph intersects that y-axis. So when we intersect that y-axis, what is this information telling us? Well, according to our data, our x values represent the years since 1900, and the y values represent the amount of oysters harvested in metric tons. So if we're at zero in the x, that means that we're intersecting that y-axis, so that's our y-intercept. And if we're at zero, there's 0 years since 1900. So we're in the year 1900 when we're on that y-axis. So the y-intercept represents the amount of oysters harvested in 1900, because that's 0 years from 1900, and that y-intercept will give us the value in metric tons of the amount of oysters harvested. So again, the y-intercept represents the amount of oysters harvested in 1900. Now we're moving on to number two with a different set of data. It says, the hurricane hunters took the following measurements from a hurricane over several days as it developed. So we have the air pressure and we have the wind speed. They found that the air pressure and wind speed are related in the following way. So they put a line of best fit to this table. And that line of best fit is y equals negative 1.24x plus 1,270, where x is that air pressure in millibars. So x represents our air pressure and y is the maximum sustained wind speed. So the wind speed in knots is what y represents. So our first question says, using the model, what would be the wind speed, so we're looking for the y value, of a hurricane with an air pressure of 980 millibars? And then we're going to round our answer to the nearest knot. So we're going to look for when x is 980 and see where on our line of best fit 980 falls and what is the y value associated with that. So here's 920, 930, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 is this line. So this is 980 millibars for the air pressure. And when it intersects that line of best fit, there is our y value. So the easiest way to do this to get a more accurate estimation is to plug in our x value into our line of best fit formula. So we'll have y equal, and that y is what we're trying to figure out, negative 1.24 times 980, because that's our x value that we're given, plus 1,270. Negative 1.24 times 980 equals negative 1,215.2, and we're going to be adding 1,270 to that. So once we add 1,270, we will get 54.8 as our wind speed in knots. However, it says to round to the nearest knot, so that nearest whole number will be 55. So 55 knots is our solution in A. So when we're at 980 in our X, we're at approximately 55 in the Y. And if we did not have this line of best fit formula, we would use our graph and guess that it would be around 60, because that's where it looks like that dot would fall on that line. However, since we were given that equation, we were able to plug in our X value and solve for Y. Now in B, it says, according to the model, a hurricane with an air pressure of 891, so that's an X value of 891, would have what wind speed? So again, we're going to use our line of best fit, plugging in 891 for X in part B. So we'll have Y equals negative 1.24, and this time we're going to be multiplying that by 891, as opposed to the previous problem where we multiplied by 980. And then we're going to add 1,270 to that. So negative 1.24 times 891 equals negative 1,104.84. And we're adding 1,270. And when we do so, we'll get 165.16. However, we need to round that to the nearest knot, so the nearest whole number, which will round down to 165. So 165 knots is our solution in B. So according to the model, when we have an air pressure of 890 millibars, we'll have a wind speed of approximately 165 knots. And then lastly, associated with this model, we're going to answer C. It says that the model indicates that a wind speed of 110 knots is associated with what air pressure? So now, since we're given the wind speed, that's our y value, we need to solve for x. So plugging in our y value of 110, that's going to equal negative 1.24 times x, which is what we're solving for, plus 1,270. So we'll start by subtracting 1,270 from both sides in order to isolate that term with x. So 110 minus 1,270 equals negative 1,160. So we'll get that negative 1,160 is equal to negative 1.24 times x. And now all we need to do in order to isolate that x is divide by negative 1.24. So dividing 1,160 by negative 1.24 will get 935.48. So 935.48 is equal to x. However, we're rounding to the nearest millibar, so that's going to be that nearest whole number, and 48 will round down, so we'll get 935 millibars as our solution in part C. And I'll go ahead and stop this video here. Join me in the next video where I'll complete the last page of this worksheet, numbers 3 and 4. However, before continuing on, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.